Hi there. So in this video, we're going to talk about finding queens. It can be a challenging thing to do. Many beekeepers dread having to look for the queen, but it can be fun too. It's kind of like going fishing or hunting. There's the thrill of the chase, and so it's an activity I quite enjoy. There are lots of little tricks that you can use to help find the queen, and you need to use all of them. And really, the biggest thing is keeping your focus, not being distracted, so that you're only trying to find the queen, not trying to do anything else. When you start to find a queen, you apply a little bit of smoke, but you don't want to apply much smoke, because that gets the bees running around, which makes it very difficult to find a queen. If the bees are running around, she's running around, and you want to try and find her where she normally would be, laying eggs on a frame, and in a normal position within the colony. So just a little bit of smoke there. It's always easier to find queens in a smaller colony like this one. So if you're going to want to practice getting better at finding queens, do so in the spring when the colonies aren't very strong and it's a little easier to find them. Ideally, you have a nice sunny day like today. When you're finding queens, it just makes it a lot easier to see the queen. So we'll take the first frame out. And what we're doing is we're looking at this side of the frame, and we're scanning across the frame and around the edges, and we're looking for the queen's abdomen. I usually recommend to people that they look at a picture of a queen and really focus on the difference between her and the worker bees, and it's her abdomen that is the most noticeably different. And that's what you're looking for, is a queen abdomen as you're scanning across the frame. You don't look at every individual bee, you don't have to, because she's enough different that abdomen will kind of jump out at you. So we scan across the frame, turn it to the other side, scan across that, and then lean it out of the way, as per usual. And we won't look at this frame because there's hardly any bees on there, not much chance she'll be there. So we'll just pry the next frame loose. Now, as we're taking this frame out, we look at the following frame, the one that's in here, because very often we'll see the queen moving down the frame. Queens always move away from the light. A mated queen will always move away from the light. So about 50% of the queens I find, I'll see them as they're moving down the next frame. Then we look at this side of the frame because it was in the dark. So the queen is more likely to be on this side than on this side. You'll see what I mean when I repeat that process on the next frame. So again, we're scanning across the frame, looking at the edges. If a queen happens to be near an edge on a frame, she'll move around to the dark side of the frame. And then you turn the frame over and she moves back to the dark side. So you've easily missed the queen when she was near an edge. So again, we'll look at the next frame. Then we'll look at this side of the frame because it was in the dark position. So we're looking at this side of the frame, scanning across. Now, just very briefly, I'm going to change my focus and I'm going to look for eggs. I see lots of eggs, so I know for sure there will be a queen. Now I forget all about eggs and just focus on looking for an abdomen. This is a colony with a spotty brood pattern, and we want to requeen this colony. So that's why we're trying to find the queen. Don't see her there. Doesn't take too long, especially if the hive isn't too strong. So you'd want to move along fairly briskly, because if it takes you a long time, then the queen can start wandering around and end up on the box or on the honey frames or so on. So I'm looking at that next frame. Now I'm looking at this side of the frame, scanning. Doing the edges first, and then the middle. Don't see her there. Keep moving through the hive methodically, one frame at a time. And she'll show up eventually. Looking at the next frame, don't see her. Looking at the dark side of this frame, not there. Brood pattern looks a little bit better here. Nope. Nope. If your eyes stop on a drone, that's good. They're noticing something different. So there's a number of frames that she could be on here, lots of frames. Oh, I see her on the next frame. So I'll just quickly lean that frame over there and pull this one up. And there she is, right there. So you see, we did find her on the frame, not in her hands, but the one that was still in the box. And you're always trying to get just a little bit ahead of the queen. What I'm going to show you now is how to cage the queen to keep her safe for while you're doing hive manipulations. Some people prefer to leave the queen on the frame and handle the frame as we showed you in working with bees, the video working with bees. In this case, we're going to actually pick up the queen and cage her. So what we do is make sure our hands are nice and clean, not too sticky, and then we approach the queen from the abdomen side. So we wait till she turns a bit, and then we approach, get her fingers right down to the comb, and then we could pick her up by very gently squeezing the thorax. Then we can just one-hand that frame into position there where it'll be nice and safe, and we've got the queen in her hand. Got a little honey on my finger, so I'll just remove that. And we've got her gently held between our thumb and forefinger. Then use a cage like this. We just pop the lid open, and there's nice big space there to drop the queen into. And we just drop her in. She goes to the bottom, and we very quickly close that lid up before she comes up and could be pinched by that cap. If she happens to get in the way before you get the lid shut, just put your thumb over and then gradually work it down. So that queen is nice and safe in that cage now. What we do then is just lean her on the top of the frames and carry on with our hive manipulations. If we were going to requeen this colony, we would just pinch the queen and not bother caging her at all. But I wanted to demonstrate that caging process in this instance. So now we'll close the hive back up. We'll put the frames back where they came. This one came out next. You can see the brood is towards the front of this frame, and so we'll put that down into place. Time for a little bit of smoke. And move these frames over. Once we get all the frames back into position, we can then reintroduce the queen, if that's what our purpose is here. So we would take the queen out by gently shaking her into her hand above the hive. We wouldn't do this on the ground, because if she fell out, she would end up in the grass and we'd have to pick her up there. So I've got her in my hand, and then I will release the queen back onto the frame, and down she goes into the dark to be nice and safe. So that's how we reintroduce a queen once we have caged her. So we always keep a quick cage like this right at hand for when we're doing hive manipulations, in order to be able to keep her safe while we're moving frames around. So that's how to find a queen, and how to cage the queen, how to release the queen, and it's a very useful skill to have when we're doing making splits or requeening colonies. Many different hive tasks require that we are able to find queens, and so there's just a few tips on how to do that. Thanks for watching. See you next time.